Alright, we're going to do a percent mixture problem. How much water should be added to 30 cups of juice that is 70% juice to get a diluted mixture that is only 60% juice? So in other words, we're trying to dilute the juice by adding water to it. So we're going to have a bigger container of juice, but the amount of pure juice in there is going to be only 60%. All right, so here's a picture. You're going to add some water to this container of juice to get a bigger container of juice, but it's going to be diluted. So notice that I did not give you the percent here for water. Well, how much juice is in water? None. So what percent of juice is in water? Zero. So you know this is just 0%. That's just going to be zero, right? When we're talking about how much pure juice. Now, what about the percent of juice here? How can I write that as a decimal? That could be 0.7, and the final mixture will be 0.6. So remember, this is just the mix, the diluted mixture of juice. We don't know how much water to put in here. In fact, it's asking us that, so that'll be our variable. But do we know how much of the 70% mixture there is? Yes, 30 cups of the 70%. So we know there's 30 cups here. So in the final mixture, you're mixing X cups of water with 30 cups of the original juice. So you'll have X plus 30 cups in the mixture. Now what we want to make sure is that we have the same amount of pure juice in these two containers as in the final container. Now the interesting thing is here, you're adding water, so you're not going to get any juice out of this container at all. Which of course, if you want to write that as an equation, 0 times x is going to be 0. So this is going to, now what we're going to do is figure out how much pure juice is in each container. Well, that'll be 0 or 0 times x, right? How much is in this container? Well, 70% of 30. And how much is in this container? 60% of x plus 30. Now remember, you can write percents in different ways. You could use fractions, you could write 0.70 or 0.60, that's up to you. But the equation is the amount of juice that there was in the original two containers has to be the same as the amount of juice at the end. So this represents the pure juice in the containers. So we have 0 plus. Now, 70% of 30 is 21. And over here, if we do our distributive property, we get 0.6x plus 0.6 times 30. Well, I think of that as 6 times 30 and then move the decimal point in. That's going to be 18. You could use a calculator as well. So, 0 plus 21 is 21. I'm going to subtract 18 from both sides. To get 0.6x equals 3. So I'm going to have to divide by 0.6. Now, at this point, you can write 0.6 in different ways. There's different ways to simplify at this part of the equation. You could just divide by 0.6 and then worry about simplifying in a minute. Let me show you another way of thinking about this. You could change this to a fraction and reduce it. Another thing you can do is multiply both sides by 10, thereby getting rid of any decimals on both sides. So I'm going to go ahead and do it that way. If I multiply this side by 10, and I'm sorry, I said 10 and wrote 100. I meant to say by 10. So we've got 30 equals 6x. And then just divide by 6, you'll get x equals 5. I'm going to write that as x equals 5. Okay. Now, you didn't have to go through that. You could have said 0.6x equals 3 divided by 0.6. And in this case, when you do use a calculator, you will come out being a whole number. But if it didn't come out as a terminating decimal, you'd have a little problem with this, right? So you'll also get it by just plugging that in a calculator or doing long division or even changing 0.6 to a fraction. So here I got 5, here I got 5. What if I change 0.6 to a fraction? That's 6 tenths or 3 fifths. x equals 3. And then if you multiply both sides by the reciprocal, you're going to get x equals 5 again. So I'm just going over some different ways to deal with simplifying when you have decimals. That's really not the main part of this problem, but no matter how you do it, you should always get x equals 5. So our next step would be to check the answer to make sure if this makes sense. When you put in 5 cups of water, does it dilute it in the right amount? All right, so we're going to check our answer now. All right, we let x be the amount of water, so we know now that 5 goes in here for how much water we're going to use. So if we put in 5 cups of water and 30 cups of the 70% juice, we'll have 35 cups of juice, right? You're adding 5 cups and 30 cups. And let's see how with the percent here. Remember, this was 0. I'm going to write percent, sorry. So if we write our percent as a decimal here, it would just be 0. And this is 0.7 times 30. And in the resulting mixture, we want, it should be 60% of those 35 gallons. We want to make sure we have the same amount of fruit juice. Okay, so this is just 0, which I don't need to write down. 0.7 times 30 is 21 cups. Now, we knew we were only going to have 21 cups because we just added water to it. But in the end, is there still exactly 21 cups? Well, 0.6 times 35 is 21. You could do that with a calculator or, you know, regular arithmetic where you multiply it out. Or you could write that 0.6, by the way, as 3/5 times 35. And don't even need a calculator. 7 times 3 is 21. Cool, huh? So, final answer is add 5 cups of water. So we checked and that was the winning amount. So there's another percent mixture problem for you. These do take a while. Just keep practicing. Think about what's going on. You're trying to make sure that the percent is talking about how much of the, you know, you're extracting the amount of salt or the amount of juice or the amount of oats, whatever the problem might be. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.